everyone, Golden Tails Geek here. Welcome back to Let's Play Wario Land 2. In the last episode, we went through the Grand Hall, and we also defeated a giant spearman inside Wario's castle. In this episode, we're going to finally kick him out. So, let's get started. Oh, and also in the last episode, I tended to ramble about stuff that just had been kind of getting on my nerves for a while now, so forgive me if it was a bit ranty in the last episode. There are some things that I just really wanted to kind of just get out of my system, I suppose. I don't know. But then again, it wouldn't be the internet if it weren't for some people expressing unpopular opinions and then other people giving them shit about it. And saying you're biased and full of shit. But, you know, whatever. The internet. Where civility is almost, all but an afterthought sometimes. Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap! Got it. That was a close call there. Whew, I lucked out there. Quite frankly, I wanted to be able to destroy that thing. Whew, got it. But anyway, I'm kind of a bit of emotional high because last night Pico streamed and I also watched the pilot episode of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., which I thought was fantastic, and I'm looking forward to seeing more of it. And I love the fact that Coulson doesn't fully know how he recovered from his murder at the hands of Loki, but you know what? I don't care. Could be like the Doctor's name in Doctor Who. Maybe we're not even meant to know. I don't know. Well, we'll see. I mean, I suspect that there won't be an explanation that'll satisfy one or the other, so it'll probably be just a riddle for the ages. Also been playing a little more Rayman Origins lately, because I just really want to be sure I get a lot. I want to finish up that game sometime. I might go back and play it again after I'm done with it, though, because it's just such a good game. I just could not get enough of it. Ooh, black coin! But yeah. I just opened it. But yeah. I'm sorry, I just don't know what to talk about right now, because I'm just kind of trying to just keep moving on and just keep having fun and just playing this game. Oh, and speaking of stuff, I actually received some pretty decent feedback on my first part of my LP. That made me happy. In fact, a couple of people I met on Pico's streams actually thought my first episode was pretty solid and actually subbed to me saying they look forward to seeing more. So let's hope it all works out, you know? I hope they continue to like my stuff because I'm looking forward to it, honestly. You know, I mean, I'm gonna be probably uploading the next episode like tomorrow, so when I wake up. So it's just God, another black coin. I'm lucking out here. Whew, awesome. I love all this stuff. Sorry, I'm just trying to think of other things to talk about while I'm working here, playing here. Yeah. Also been trying to decide what I want to LP next, because quite frankly, sooner or later, I'm going to be done with this LP, and I'm going to have to move on to the next one, and I still haven't decided what might be the next one to do, you know? I mean, that's the problem with being a Let's Player, actually, is that I've found, is that, you know, you gotta keep things fresh and interesting. Although, I do like, one of my favorite comments that I received on my first episode was basically just saying, like, you know, I've never seen, this looks like you're gonna have a very interesting LP. I look forward to seeing how it all plays out, because... And it's actually someone I saw on Twitter who basically takes upon himself to help out other LPers, kind of not necessarily get known, but just help them kind of build their own kind of Let's Playing identity, shall we say, I guess. So let's just hope it all pans out, because I'd love that. And I just hope I won't be boring people. That's the key thing, is that I don't want to bore people. And I'm probably boring people right now with all this crap of just exploring every little facet and detail. You know, it's just... I don't know what to say, really. I'm just happy that I had such a good response, you know? I mean, especially since the internet is, like, YouTube is pretty much clogged up with LPers and whatnot. I mean, that me just being the latest one probably doesn't help matters. And, like I said, I've been meaning to do LPs for almost 2 years now, so it's just really nice to finally get some feedback on something like this. I just kind of wish I could know what some of my friends thought, but other friends thought, but... Oh well, I haven't heard from them yet, so let's hope it all works. Sorry for going quiet, I just wanted to concentrate for a minute. But yeah, I'm nervous and excited and just looking forward to just seeing, I just really want this LP to do well. I mean, granted, every person's first LP is a bit stumbly and you're still working on trying to find your voice, as it were. It's just, I don't know, it's just... I'm just really hoping it just... I'm at a loss for words right now. I really am. But, you know... So, yeah. Also, just been a bit antsy because it's like almost... It's gonna be a month before the 50th anniversary of Doctor Who. Soon, and I'm just looking forward to seeing that, and just... There's all this stuff going on there. And also, my friend Sarah is, like, talking about maybe wanting to go to PAX East next year, and I'm just like, oh, God. I'd love to go to PAX East, I really would, but, you know. But, you know, I don't know how my parents would feel about that, but, you know, we'll see. And, yeah. And the usual, you know the drill, folks. Treasure time. In fact, someone suggested I cut out like the saving and stuff, so I didn't have to have it clog up the video. But he said it wasn't that big of a complaint. So, damn it. So, but otherwise, he really enjoyed it. So. I'm just hoping that all works out, really, because I just really want to... I don't know. I'm sorry if I keep saying that I hope it all works out, it's just I'm really nervous, okay? It's my first LP. I just really want it to work. I really do. Yes! Got it! Awesome. Whew, that was close. And I can't even tell what that is. Hang on, I'm gonna check... Looks like some weird football helmet. So, yeah. And if you couldn't tell by the fact that it's final story, then it's leading up to a final boss thing scenario where you basically beat the game. So it's another alternate ending. So yeah, that's usually the case when you see final story in the chapter, is basically it means it's basically like multiple ending time, yeah. Personally, I look at the really final chapter's ending as the canonical, like, final ending after defeating Captain Syrup, you know? But, you know, whatever. I mean, then again, when it comes to Mario and canon, it's a bit tenuous to begin with. Shit. That's what I get for just trying to go after every single little frickin' coin. End up wasting more of your time here. Oh well. Excuse me. And I would have recorded this sooner today, but my older brother came over and he wanted to kind of talk about, we talked about the video I posted on YouTube that a friend of mine posted on their Facebook, commenting on it. So yeah. He thought it was cool that I'm finally doing something like that to kind of just kind of give myself a little hobby and also to show off how much I really love games. So he's been really supportive, so, and I appreciate that. You know, even though I'm basically on the internet, basically putting myself out there, which is pretty precarious in and of itself, and I know my dad probably would be a little bit uncomfortable with that, but you know, as long as it probably feels that as long as I don't give away too much about myself, then they're probably fine with it. So, oh well, what are you gonna do? Wow, exactly 600 coins. Good lord. Ugh. Also, like they did in the Syrup Castle, the last Syrup Castle episode, I'm gonna, if I do screw up on the picture panel game, and I need to redo it, I will cut out any attempts to redo the boss fight just to make sure I get it right, you know? Okay. Just making sure, folks. Sorry. I just wanted to make sure I got everything here before moving on to the boss. Let's save again. I think this is like the Mecha Spearman. I don't know exactly what it's called, but basically, you know, you just gotta avoid him until his power starts to wind down. It's going slower than molasses. And he's going to get a recharge from Captain Syrup, you body slam him. It honestly took me a while to figure out how to beat this boss. But thankfully, now, thankfully this boss has a simple enough attack pattern that you're able to figure it out. He starts walking slowly. Turns red. That means it's the final hit. Or he's just rusting out. Rusting. I don't know. You can never tell with these limited color schemes on Game Boy Color games. Oh well. Bonk. Alright. Avoid those and got it! Simple and easy as banana cream pie. Let's play. I see what I did there. Anyway, let's do this. It's a 4. Yay! I don't have to cut anything! Hooray! And that makes for another ending in the bag. Save the game. And let's let the game credits play out again. Captain Syrup and the goons are gone. Yay! Mario gets rid of the Black Sugar Pirate King symbol. And he goes back to sleep. I love that snoring sound. Although, I do hope his flooding insurance is paid up, but, you know, what are you gonna do? And I know, and you know what, since I don't have anything serious to talk about, we're just gonna enjoy the credits music. And now I'm gonna basically comment on the names of the staff. Here. Because I didn't have a chance to talk about that during the credits last time. Director! Ozokawa Takehiro. I feel like I've seen him do other games, but I can't remember. Oh well, we'll see. I love the credits music. It's just so happy. Dang it. Note to self, do not try to sing along with the credits music when your throat is really dry. Sorry, I just love the credits music and I don't really know what else to talk about. Sorry. I gotta stop singing along because it's just, I don't know. Ueda Masani. I've seen him do other games, so he's not the only one I've seen do these kind of games. So yeah, that's cool. And I just repeated myself only differently. God. Matsumura Satoshi. Japanese names. Nishikawa Kozu. Although I think it's supposed to be the other way around, but what do I know? I'm kind of wondering what else Kozu Ishikawa has done in terms of music, because I can't remember. I feel like I've seen his name before. Sano Shin, I've seen before. Fukui Kota, Yamane Tomoyoshi, Hirano Isao. My Japanese pronunciations could use a little work. Super Mario Club! I still would love to join that as well, Chugga, so you're not alone in that regard. From what I understand, that they're supposed to, they're like a group of playtesters still, so... I don't know. Drodusa! Oh yeah, I forgot all about that! Is it like in this ending, you know, where you see the little word bubble of him going... Whoa, right. Yeah, sorry, I must have drifted off there. Not just kidding. Anyway, let's see what our totals are this time for beating the game. Stage clear. 60%. Treasure. 60%. And the picture panel. 60%. So far, so good. Well, as we're not done yet, folks, we still got like 4 more chapters left to do. So, I think I'm going to let you guys off here. So, next time on Let's Play Wario Land 2, we will be going into the next chapter, which is opened up after you go through the secret level, or the secret exit in the Defeat the Giant Snake level. Wait, what does that entail? I guess you'll find out, won't you? So, until then, this has been Golden Tales Geek, and I wish you guys to have the best day ever. And thank you for watching. Goodbye!